Hey, what's up everybody? It's Cory, and today I'm gonna do a quick review over two extremely great options for concealed carry, the Sig Sauer P365 9mm and the Glock 43 9mm. Both of these guns are standard stock versions of the firearm. This is what you get, other than the green laser that I've had installed on the Glock 43 from Crimson Trace. I'm gonna do a quick review. I'm gonna talk about the things I like, the things I don't like, and my personal experience with each firearm. Y'all stay tuned. For the pistols, we're gonna be shooting at this steel silhouette. Maybe compare the Glock 43 and the Glock, the Glock 43 and the Sig P365, and we're just gonna have a little bit of fun. So here we go. I'm gonna start off talking about the Glock 43. I'm not gonna go in depth on either one of these firearms. I'm just gonna mention what really stands out to me personally. Both of them are extremely similar in size and concealability, especially I carry the crossbreed holster with both firearms. And the biggest advantage for this firearm is its size and its concealability. It's extremely thin, and if you have this in a inside the waistband holster or an appendix carry holster, nobody's gonna know you have it. You can be wearing business casual clothing, you could be wearing something like this at the gun range, whatever it is, nobody's gonna know that you're carrying this firearm. The drawbacks for this gun, for me personally, is the magazine size. This is only gonna carry 6 rounds in the magazine plus 1 in the chamber. And also with that is just the grip size. This is the extended magazine here, but my pinky still doesn't really have anywhere to go. So whenever I'm on target, I don't have as much leverage on the gun, and I have trouble keeping that front sight. Well, not trouble, it's just not as easy for me to keep that front sight on target, especially in a rapid fire situation. So those are the two drawbacks on this firearm for me. Outside of that, I absolutely love this gun. And it was honestly one of those things that I didn't fully notice until I shot the Sig Sauer P365. All right, we're gonna start off. We're gonna put 6 rounds down range with the Glock 43 on the steel silhouette. Full disclosure, I am a Glock fanboy. I've always loved Glocks, I've always shot Glocks, and I never thought I would consider anything other than carrying a Glock. That is until I shot this for a concealed carry pistol. This is the Sig Sauer P365. One of the best features about this gun is the concealability while also having the capacity that it does in the magazine. With the extended magazine, you can carry 12 rounds plus 1. And when you look at the P365 next to the Glock 43, these guns are virtually the exact same size, but here you have double the capacity. And for me, that's the biggest leap forward and the biggest advantage that this firearm has over the Glock 43. Both are great for concealment. Both are extremely reliable firearms. However, this just gives you such an advantage over the 43. The only complaint I have about this firearm is whenever you're shooting this with the regular magazine that comes with it, the grip actually digs into my palm. So after, you know, 100 rounds, 200 rounds, I actually get kind of a blister, or like it's been rubbed raw on the palm of my hand. So extended time on the range with this firearm with the regular magazine, which only holds 9 rounds, is very aggressive on my palm, and I just don't like it. So I highly recommend you pay for the extended magazine. You get the extra 3 round capacity. It's almost like carrying a Glock 43 without the size, a Glock 19 without the extra size. And I just love the control that you have on the gun. It fits perfectly in my hand. So whenever I'm shooting down range, I've got full leverage and full control. I'm able to keep that front sight on target, as opposed to the control that I did not have with the Glock 43. All right, we're gonna shoot the P365. We're gonna put 6 rounds down range on the steel silhouette. Anyways, that's my overview of the Glock 43 and the Sig Sauer P365. I absolutely love both of these guns for concealed carry. However, I feel like the P365 is a clear winner whenever you're looking at magazine capacity, reliability, and control if you upgrade to the extended magazine. I don't remember how much that was, but I can tell you it was worth it. So now that we've talked about these, if y'all have any questions, be sure and leave a comment down in the comment section. I'm gonna shoot some rounds down range. I hope you're doing well, and I'll catch y'all next time.